Hello, and welcome. The long-awaited day has arrived where I share with you the best things that happened throughout the month. This time, we had the return of a Ryujinx fork for Android, bringing yet another option for mobile devices, rumors that the official Vita 3K might also return to Android, a new update for Yaba Sanshiro, a new and promising Sega Saturn emulator, two Mario games with decompilation now complete, Mario Kart 64 and Mario Party 4 for the GameCube, the CEMU recompiler being rewritten, which could bring significant performance improvements to the emulator, including on Android. More than 20 fixed games in PCSX2, as well as new features like Auto HDR, the release of Eden, and much more. Starting with Sega Saturn news, Yaba Sanshiro 2, currently the most up-to-date emulator for the console, available for Android, Windows, and other platforms, received modest updates, but they bring visual and competitive improvements. The system now displays the ratings users gave for each game, along with an evaluation of the emulation status. You can also write your own review, which will be visible to other users. In the latest update, a leaderboard was also added. There aren't many supported games for it yet, but for now, it allows users to compare the best times in Sonic R, and more games will likely be added in the future. Another emulator that recently appeared and impressed me was Ymir, a new Sega Saturn project still in its early stages. However, it already has a decent interface and supports joystick input via SDL API, in addition to rendering both 2D and 3D games well. The only downsides I noticed were the lack of compatibility with CHD files, the most used format nowadays due to saving space, and the absence of tools to improve graphics, such as polygon or shadow enhancements. Ymir is available for Windows, Mac, and Linux. There's no Android version yet, but I recommend keeping an eye on this project. It looks promising. In the decompilation scene, we had two major breakthroughs. Mario Kart 64, which had been in the decompilation process for a while, finally reached 100%, just like Mario Party 4 for the GameCube. While Mario Kart 64 doesn't have a functional launcher to run it directly yet, all the necessary documentation is now available for someone to create an executable with menus and custom options. It's considered by many one of the best Mario Kart games of all time. As for Mario Party 4, it already appears to be playable. It's the first fully decompiled GameCube game, and for those who want to compile and run it natively on Windows or Linux, I'll leave the links in the description. Since I don't have experience with this kind of thing, I usually don't even try, but for those who understand it, it's a great opportunity. The addition of these two games opens many doors, both for mods, like HD textures, new language additions, and graphical improvements, and for releases on platforms that would never officially get these games, such as Android or even the PlayStation 2. A great example of that was the Super Mario 64 decompilation, which eventually got ported even to the PS2. Speaking now of CEMU, the project is going strong. Even after many people forgot how great this emulator is, it still manages to surprise. The PR called Large-Scale PowerPC is rewriting CEMU's recompiler, the module responsible for translating the Wii U's CPU instructions so they can be understood by a PC. This rewrite should greatly improve the experience on Android, which is already decent, but still far from ideal. For Windows, the improvements could also be significant, such as the addition of features that allow the game to pause completely or even the possibility of implementing save states in the future. At the moment, it's still unclear if this new approach will bring performance gains, as large-scale testing hasn't been done yet. The version with this new recompiler hasn't been released, but everything indicates it'll be available soon. As soon as it's out, I'll let you know here on the channel. And from what it looks like, although it hasn't been confirmed yet, the original developer of Vita 3K for Android, who had stopped working on the project after version 12, seems to be back. Although version 12 fixed several issues, it also introduced new bugs. Recently, the developer left a comment saying that a possible version 13 could be released between Saturday and Sunday. However, the date has passed and no new version has been released, so it's still unclear if the comeback is actually happening, especially considering the last official version came out over a year ago. Either way, I'll leave a link to the original project in the description in case you want to follow it closely or download future versions if they do come out. In our last news video, I mentioned that another developer is working on a continuation of the project, under the name Vita 3K12.5. This one is actually being actively updated, and at the time of this video's publication, it's already on build 14, released exactly 3 weeks ago. I'll also leave a link to this version for anyone interested in following the development, or downloading the latest builds. For now, we just have to wait and see if version 13 will finally be released, and if it does, let's hope it brings real improvements to the PS Vita scene on Android. If you want to buy original games while saving a lot, check out Instant Gaming, the digital store that sells games for various platforms, such as PC, PlayStation, Xbox, and Nintendo Switch. Get games of all genres with discounts of up to 95%. You'll also find a variety of gift cards and credits for other services. You can pay for your order through your credit card on a website with a 4.7 rating on Trustpilot. You're buying games directly from Instant Gaming, not from other retailers. If you encounter any issues, Instant Gaming offers 24/7 support. And this month, Instant Gaming is offering a great discount on the newly released Monster Hunter Wilds, with up to 51% off, ensuring the lowest historical price for the game. Check out the price comparison with Steam's pricing. What are you waiting for to save? Links in the description. Another great piece of news for Android is that our dear Kenji the Bot, the one behind the excellent Ryujinx fork for Windows, Kenji-NX, has just released an improved version of his fork for Android. That means we once again have a fully functional Ryujinx fork on Android. For those who don't know Kenji, and you really should, he's an extremely proactive guy in the community, unlike others like Green, who runs Ryubing and is often involved in controversy. Kenji is discreet, helpful, and treats everyone with respect, the way it should be. His Ryujinx fork is usually a little behind Ryubing in terms of features, mainly because he's working solo, handling both the Windows and Android versions. But since it's based on Ryujinx, it behaves differently from Yuzu forks, which means some games that don't run well on Yuzu may work just fine on Kenji-NX. A great example is FIFA 23. On Yuzu forks, there's a missing player indicator cursor, but on Kenji-NX, that issue is gone. Another plus is the good performance on Mali GPUs, something many forks still struggle with. If you want, I can run some full tests with Kenji-NX on my Snapdragon device over the next few days. Either way, I'll leave links to both of Kenji's forks in the description. I highly recommend giving them a try. And unless you've been trapped in a cave without internet these past weeks, you probably already know that we now have a pre-alpha version of Aiden available, open for testing and with a dedicated feedback space on Discord. The link will also be in the description. Just to be clear, Kenji was one of the first people to join the Aiden Discord, and although he wasn't directly involved in Aiden's development nor is he listed in the credits, he has been offering guidance since the early days of Citrin. Camille has always made sure Kenji had his own dedicated space in the project's Discord, since Kenji doesn't run a community of his own. So we can consider these emulators as allies. Aiden has no issues with Kenji, and Kenji has no issues with Aiden. Unfortunately, part of the community insists on creating rivalry between the two projects, when in reality, they'd definitely work together if they could. Camille was actually one of the first people to promote Kenji's project in the Aiden Discord announcements section. So if you're one of those trying to stir up drama between the projects, please stop. The emulation community already has enough drama. What we need is unity. Besides, the projects are written in different languages, which means games that run poorly on one fork might work flawlessly on the other. Instead of competing, why not root for both and help these emulators grow? Still on the topic of Nintendo Switch, very quietly, Nintendo has converted Mario Kart 8 into a 64-bit application, likely due to future incompatibility of the upcoming Switch 2 with 32-bits. For emulation, especially on Android, this change brings a real performance boost. If you've been following Yuzu forks for Android since the beginning, you'll remember that the NC backend didn't support 32-bits. The team was working on it, but the project ended before support could be implemented. Even simple games like New Super Mario Bros. U could suffer from lower-than-expected performance on certain devices because of this. Now, with Mario Kart 8 converted to 64-bit, you can simply select the NC backend on your device and that's it. Stutters are completely gone. If you've been waiting to play this game, just update it to the latest version and enjoy everything your device has to offer. And who said older emulators don't bring new features? PCSX2, which for years looked like a stall project, is now surprising everyone with constant updates, practically every quarter. Let's start with a feature I personally really like, especially for those with modern monitors, HDR support. Dolphin added this recently, and the improvement in color range is impressive. Now, PCSX2 is heading down the same path, though still in the early stages and far from ready for everyday use. Another cool feature is pressure sensitivity support, something heavily used in games like Metal Gear and Ace Combat. Right now, this only works with PS3 controllers connected via cable, since that feature was removed starting with the DualShock 4. They also added in Align to Native, option that improves 3D rendering accuracy in games like Ace Combat, God of War, Catwoman, Madagascar, Final Fantasy VII Dirge of Cerberus, and Project Snowblind. And the cherry on top, the PR titled. Implement RT and RT support, which improves the way rendering layers are stacked, something that's always been an issue on PCSX2, especially when using upscaling. This update specifically benefits the following games: Battlefield 2, Call of Duty World at War, Death by Degrees, Delta Force Black Hawk Down, Drakengard, Drive 3R, Haunting Ground, Hitman Blood Money, Hitman Contracts, Jack X Combat Racing, Peter Jackson's King Kong, Manhunt 2, Onimusha Warlords, Ridge Racer V, Suikoden 3, Sweat Global Strike Team, Tekken 5, Taka Race Driver 2, Tomb Raider Legends, Urban Reign, and Wild Arms 5. The full list will be in the pinned comment of this video. If you want to download any of these emulators, the complete list will be on our Patreon blog, completely free. No subscription or account creation needed to access the links. And that's it for today's video. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel to keep up with all the latest emulation news. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.